Hey, what is up, mortals? It's Kiki Cakes here with a new video for you. In this video, we'll dive into Miss Joke from the My Hero Academia anime. I just wanted to greet you guys by saying sit back and relax, you're in for a treat, so let's get started. In this deep dive, we'll be talking about Emi Fukukado, better known as her hero name of Miss Joke. The earliest we know of Miss Joke's history is that she worked at a hero agency close to where Aizawa was working, and at that time they became acquainted and worked with each other in some incidents. Eventually, Miss Joke became a teacher at Ketsubutsu Academy High School, and the first time we saw her in the series was during the UA Sports Festival where she was in the stands. At the event, we also got a close-up of her after Izuku and Shinso's battle, where she talks to the heroes around her about how good Shinso's quirk is and how it was disappointing that he was only in general studies. We don't see Miss Joke again until the day of the Provisional Hero License exam, where she is with her students from Ketsubutsu Academy High School. At the event, she excitedly goes to talk to Aizawa, although he doesn't reciprocate the excitement, instead wanting her to go away. This doesn't drive her away, however. Instead, she continues talking to Aizawa and the students of 1A, telling the kids about their past partnership and even claiming that they had feelings for one another, but Aizawa denies this. Miss Joke also introduces her students to Class 1A before instructing the kids to go get into their hero costumes. When the event starts, Aizawa and Miss Joke sit with one another while watching their respective students, and during the exam, Miss Joke attempts to flirt and tease Aizawa, which he ignores as much as he can. Miss Joke also points out how every year the UA students get targeted by the other schools since all of the UA students' quirks are broadcasted at the sports festival, but Aizawa says that isn't important in the scheme of things. Miss Joke becomes impressed when 1A is able to survive their repeated attacks, not being phased and simply overcoming them. She continues talking to Aizawa and eventually asks him why he hadn't expelled any students in his class, claiming that he might be fond of his class, but he denies this, not convincing Miss Joke at all. During the second test, consisting of rescue operations, Miss Joke is shocked when Gang Orca and his sidekicks appear, acting as the enemies for the test. After the test is over, and most of both Miss Joke and Aizawa's classes pass, Miss Joke suggests doing joint training with both classes in the future, which Aizawa agrees to do. We next see Miss Joke in March, where she's informed that Hawks is acting as a spy to get info on the Paranormal Liberation Front. And with his information, the police and the heroes organize a raid to take down the organization. During the operation, Miss Joke gets put on a large team meant to raid the Goonga Mountain Villa, which is the main headquarters of the Paranormal Liberation Front. When the raid starts, the heroes catch the Paranormal Liberation Front guards by surprise and are able to defeat a large number before the villains can adequately defend themselves. As of right now, that's all we know about Miss Joke's history, so now let's move on to her appearance. Miss Joke is a young 29-year-old woman with an athletic build with noticeably muscular arms. She has green hair that goes past her shoulders and a short fringe with splayed ends, which typically obscure her bandana. Miss Joke also has dark green eyes with bright pupils, but her most prominent feature is her constant joyous smile. Miss Joke's hero costume consists of a navy blue shirt with a high collar that buttons up to her chin, also sporting a puffed-up pair of shorts with a green and orange pinstripe design. And on top of that, she wears a corset adorned with yellow smiley face pins that dip down in a shallow U in the center. She also wears a white V-shaped belt and sports a pair of padded yellow gloves with golden plates over her knuckles and lower fingers, which extends with orange-striped tubes going down to her lower arms with thick metal cylinders on the wrists acting as guards. She also wears an orange bandana, and at times we've seen her wearing a white hygiene mask with a circular smiley face protrusion on each side. This mask also allows her to neutralize her quirk in public. We've also seen her in her typical civilian attire, in which she wears a long skirt that goes down to her ankles with a button-up shirt and suspenders. Moving on to Miss Joke's personality, she's very cheerful and outgoing. She also acts goofy and somewhat obnoxious, always trying to take any chance to make someone laugh. She takes no shame in flirting with Aizawa in any situation and wants to try to break his cold exterior and force him to smile. She also enjoys poking fun at him, finding his stoic personality amusing, which perfectly shows off her playful and teasing nature. Her playful attitude plays into her hero work since she fights by distracting her enemies with laughter. Although her personality makes her appear unprofessional, Miss Joke is able to take her job as a teacher and pro hero seriously, clearly having an understanding of heroics and teaching. Miss Joke deeply values her students and believes in them and their abilities, and she takes offense to Aizawa placing his students above her own, instead believing in every kid's dream to become great heroes. She also seems distasteful of UA High School at times because they think that they hold an elitist attitude and overvalue their prestige. Moving on to Miss Joke's abilities, she's a skilled hand-to-hand combatant, using a strategy of incapacitating her enemies with her quirk before taking them down in hand-to-hand combat. The quirk that makes her fighting process pliable is called Outburst, which when activated forces the user's target to burst into uncontrollable laughter, and it's able to impair the opponent's cognitive abilities, giving the user an opening to take them down. Thank you all for indulging yourselves in all this information thus far. I hope you enjoyed it. Now there are a few more things I'd like to go over before the video ends. Firstly, if you're in the mood for some great storytelling, We the Celestials has got you covered. Our We the Celestials, My Hero Academia, and Naruto What If channels retell the stories of their namesake anime with a twist. Check it out if you're interested. Secondly, on behalf of We the Celestials, I'd like to thank everyone involved in the production of today's awesome content. Their details can be found in the description below. Lastly, if you're interested in what we do here at We the Celestials, then I'd like to extend you an invitation to join the team. The only caveat being that we only accept members from 16 years and up to join our crew. You can sign up for whichever category fulfills your interest by joining the recruitment Discord using the link in the description below. We're always looking for members to join us. Well, that's it from us for today's video, so thank you all for watching and have a great day!